This is a Teagle Tomahawk 50-50. We had a the same thing except a 40-40 model. The only difference is this is a bigger barrel. We can run the 5-foot bales. The one we had before, you could just do the 4-foot round bales. But it also had an extension on it that you could do the large square bales. Like I said, I really didn't like running the large square bales, just mostly because it was a lot of weight. You had a 1,000-pound bale in there, cantilevered out that far. Without a pretty large tractor, and we've got bigger tractors, but it just the way it was cantilevered, you just couldn't go without lifting the front end of your tractor up all the time, you know, if you're going uphill at all, and it kept breaking stuff. Smaller model. I mostly run it on my larger tractor with 1,000 RPM PTO. I actually haven't switched over to 540 right now because I wanted to test it out, see how my smaller Kubota ran. I was just curious, so I switched them. But I mostly always run it with 1,000 RPM PTO, which is great. It just gets the bales out faster.
Does it shred it finer too because it's chopping faster?
I wouldn't say finer. It gets the bales out a lot faster. You can run it a little lower. Like I run the tractor a little lower RPMs. I'm going through a little less diesel. And it just shreds the bale faster, you know. I think I tend to run the PTO RPM at about 800 or something at PTO when I'm shredding with this. And as opposed to like when I'm running out of the fight with a 540, I'm full throttle, you know. It really needs to be running full throttle to get enough speed to chop well.
Yeah.
Where running at 1,000, I can run a little lower. But yeah, it makes a huge difference. I know some people have an additional chute specifically for strawberries that been thinking about adding on, building something onto this for that. But I tend to be able to, I can make it work with this because I'm, the additional chute I think is nice to really just like dump all of the straw on one bed beside you as you go. Where I'm with this, I tend to kind of like, I'll run it down and I'm covering, you know, a bed and filling the pads around it quite a bit in a pass, you know. So it's not quite as direct over top of a bed, but I like to get a lot of straw like in the paths and on the bed and everything build up quite a bit. So
is that your final step or do you go out afterward and spread the straw out some more?
There's times we'll go and do a little hand work after, just if there's like places where I dump too much and then lighter places, and we might do a little touch up, but now, yeah, this is basically final step. Yeah. Our first years here, like I said, our first year, we were using large square bales. The bale shredder we had was in rough shape. It really wasn't designed to be running that heavy of bales, and it kept having breakdowns. And so we finally, we just said, screw it, we're spreading by hand for this season. And we finished the field by hand with a wagon pulling those large square bales and just dropping it off the back of the wagon.
Just shaking it out?
Yeah.
Whoa.
The second year, we had bales, round bales, and bale shredder. And I started having problems with my tractor right at the time when we were spreading. I was getting pretty nervous. I didn't have time to get the repairs done. Got to get the straw on right now. And my wife and I ended up spreading the remainder of the field, which was probably about 2 acres by hand with round bales. When they're worn out, it's working a lot harder. It's a lot slower to spread and your tractor's just working a whole lot harder. So replacing these knives especially. Last time I used it, the one came off.
Oh jeez.
Yeah, so I've got a replacement already. I'll put that on. But keeping these knives in good condition and just spending the money every so many years to replace them makes a world of difference. I learned that pretty quick.